Good morning, good morning, good morning. I'm a little teed because I started a video and someone called my phone and shut the whole video down. So I know from now on, whenever I block, to put do not disturb so they can't call. Like, it deleted my whole video. So now I have to do another one and try to say the same thing I just said over again. So on the other video, I was basically talking about how I never blog when I wake up. This was the first time I like cut on a camera when I just opened my eyes. So yeah, if I'm looking a little rough or sounding a little raspy, it's because I just woke up. Like I was saying how it was hard. I woke up and I'm like, okay. I took my medicine and I don't feel like when I used to wake up in the morning, I used to get to thinking. I don't get that anymore. So it's just like, okay, what do we do today? I gotta make a plan, you know? So I'm going to get up out this bed, that's for sure. I don't have that feeling anymore where I want to just lay in a bed all day, you know. Then I was saying on the other video, the side effects of the medication makes my throat sore. I don't know where that comes from, but I've had a sore throat and it's like so irritating. And I was also saying on the other video that, you know, I wish I could have kept in touch with my buddies and rehab, because I know when they got out, like, they were hit with, like, when you get out of rehab, when you're in rehab, you have this, like, well, people don't like it, but it's a peacefulness. It's not a peacefulness, really, because, you know, it's like a, it's, only thing you worried about is when you're getting out, and then the things that you're going to have to deal with when you get out. When you're in there, you can't worry about nothing else because you can't do anything. You can't leave. You can't go play on Facebook. You can't do none of that. So that stuff is obsolete. You know, you just got to worry about getting well. That's it. So you could get out. And I wish, like, we could keep in touch, because when you get out, then you have that support. Like, hey, how are you doing today? Is your medicine working for you? You know, if you had your friends. I was saying, I don't really care if I ever have any followers. I don't care if I never meet anybody on here. This is my journal to look back on and be like, wow, that's where I was. And this is where I am now. And wow, that's a big difference. You know, like, I wanted to track. I wanted to track my progress, and this was the way to track my progress, to record every day, to see. I've been fighting medication for so long, fighting not to take it. So now that I took it, I want to track my progress. I want to see how it really does. Is it really working? And it is really working, because I look back at my Facebook videos and I'm like, oh my God, I was horrible. I was absolutely horrible. And now it's like a different me. It's like a different me. I'm not on here to put on makeup or to be pretty. I'm not trying. I mean, I can be pretty, but I'm not really on here trying to be pretty. It's not about that. It's about me blogging every day so I can see, you know, so I can see, like, the progress that I make. And I was thinking maybe to get on my Facebook page to tell people to follow me or subscribe if you have depression, but I really don't want the Facebook attention, because people on Facebook are not always nice, you know. But I may think about it. I may. I was saying, you know, every day I wake up, I got this void or this sadness because my mom passed away. And I think I struggle with that the most out of everything. I struggle with that the most. And it's like it's a void and it can't be filled because it was my mother. So at first I was doing destructive things that made me block it or seem like it covered it up like a band-aid, but it really wasn't covering up. It was really only making it worse. There's nobody to talk to, so I talk to the camera, unfortunately. I'm gonna blog every day until I go on a vacation. It's like the vacation of my dreams. And when I get ready to go on that vacation, that's going to be my high point right there. And I'm going to do it. Watch. We're going to go from sad. Every day we're going to. The video started off sad, but I'm going to make them funny. I just need to just like. Get. It's like a bowling. This is how I see it. It's like a bowling ball. It's a bowling ball rolling. So I'm like the bowling ball at the very beginning. But when I bowl, my balls go slow. So I'm not one of those fast bowlers that bowl and the ball goes like 75 miles and it hits all the pins. No, when I bowl, my ball goes so slow. It's like this. So that's what I feel like. I'm like, I feel like I'm like a bowling ball going real slow right now. And when I get to where I want to be, which is to the pins, to knock them all down, then that's when I feel I accomplished everything I accomplished. But right now, I'm like a bowling ball just going so slow, so slow, so slow. And I'm going to get there one day. I'm just not there right now. I'm not there right now. But I will be. I try to think of things to do. You know, like, one day I went to JB. I can't, Brew House, I want to say. I went there. And it was nice. And then yesterday I went to Applebee's. And sat down and had an appetizer. You know, like, the key is to, like, don't stay in the house. Keep yourself active. No matter how you feel, you gotta keep yourself active. And I noticed when I was out, I was laughing. And I haven't laughed in, like, a long time. I have not laughed in a long time. You gotta keep yourself active. If you don't keep yourself active, then it's gonna be hard. You gotta make yourself. And that's hard for a person struggling with depression to make yourself. Regular people don't understand that. They think it's easy. Oh, just get out of bed, just do this. Regular people, you will never understand. People that's going through the struggle that I'm going through, you understand. It's hard to make yourself, but you have to make yourself. You have to make yourself. You have to. Because if you don't make yourself, you'll stay stuck in that slump. So, I make myself. I do these videos to remind myself. Like I said, I may never get any followers. I don't care. I really don't. just long as this is a progress that I can look back on and be like, okay, I came from here to here. If I have to leave this as a legacy for my kids to look at, so they'll know, dang, my mom tried hard. It'll be for them. It's not for everybody. I don't care. Like, friends are not important to me. Friends aren't friends anyway. In your life, you're only going to meet one or two people that's really your friend. Like, one or two people that you can really, 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 really. And I'm not even going to say one or two because some people have more. But for me, it's maybe one or two people that I can actually call on, that I can actually rely on, and I can actually depend on. Everybody else, it's just me. Friends are friends. Friends abuse the word friendship. People abuse the word love. People don't know the meaning of loyalty. People have no values, no morals. And when you don't have those things, but you lie and you say you do, that's when you create fake friendships. That's when you, what's the word I'm looking for? You, I'm trying to think of this one word where people believe you, but because the person thinks that you're loyal and you're not, it's a word that I'm looking for. You, I cannot think of that word to save my life. It's miss something where you fake it. Like you tricking a person. You trick them because they really thought, like, you know, that you were this person and you wasn't. It's a lot of people out there like that. I don't know what's wrong with these people. Like, I may be crazy, but I still have morals. I still have values. And I'm not going to say I trust everybody because I don't. I don't trust everybody. It's only one or two people that I really honestly trust. Because people lie. People, to me, it's like we living in a world with wolves, with sheep's clothing. And this is not the paranoia. This is real, real, real talk. Like, we really do live in a world with, and I don't care what people say. They can get on here and be like, oh yeah, she's cuckoo. But you can say I'm cuckoo all you want, but I'm pretty sure you came across people who pretended they was one way, but they were a whole nother way. And I call them sheeps. I call them wolves in sheep's clothing. Because really, they're evil inside. You know? Not evil as far as paranoid where people thinking like, oh, she crazy. No, they're evil where they'll use you to get what they want. And they really don't even give a damn about your feelings. And when it's your turn, when you need their help, they're nowhere around. Nowhere around. You can't even call them to get a freaking dollar. You can't call them for $5. But they'll suck you dry. They'll suck you dry telling you their problems or calling you when they need you. But let you need them. Nowhere around. And that's not being negative. That's just being the truth because I'm like, I'm living in the same world y'all living in. And I'm wondering, am I seeing how corrupt people are? Am I seeing how men are changing? You know, I actually have some male friends that really feel like women is supposed to support them. I even seen it when I was in a hospital where a man has taken a role of, if you're not going to do this for me, I'm not going to talk to you. And I'm like, wait a minute, you a man. How is a woman supposed to take care of you? You're a man. Like, you supposed to take care of yourself. A woman isn't supposed to take care of you. I can understand where some men don't want to fully take care of a woman because, you know what I'm saying? They want a woman to have their own. You know, they want a woman to be independent. But for a man to ask anything of a woman, and especially if she's not your wife, you know what I'm saying? And you haven't even been with her for a year. How can you expect a woman to give you money? You're a grown ass man. How can you expect a woman to feed you? Or you are a grown ass man. You're supposed to be the protector. What are you then if you're not protecting? I can't condone in that. Like, I don't see. I think women be so desperate to have a man. They will accept anything. Just to have a piece of a man. Just to say, oh, he's the only one I have. We love each other. So I'm his ride or die. No. Fuck that. And fuck that man. I'd rather ride and die by myself. I mean, but that's my opinion. Every woman may need that man's support. But me, no. I'll ride by myself. I was born by myself, and I'm gonna die by myself. I don't need a man that's bugging me on me paying him money or me trying to find him something to eat. What the fuck is you even with me for? If you not with me, you against me. You doing more harm than good. Like, you know, I could do bad by myself. I don't need you weighing me down with your problems. I got my own problems. The fuck do I need a man for? And I'm not one of them new school women that bash men. I'm not that. I don't want to bash a man. You know what I'm saying? I could do this. I could do that. No. I'm not bashing men at all. I just think that a man should play his role as a partner. That's all I'm saying. I don't think a man should want to try to take on the role that a woman takes where he wants a woman to take care of him. I don't believe that. So, in saying that, I'm just saying, like, I just don't understand these new school men. And it could never be me. It could never be me. I could never deal with a man that's bugging me to do stuff for him. I mean, unless you really have done a lot for me, like you've been through the ringer with me, then yeah. If you've been through the ringer with me, yeah, I will pay your phone bill because it was times when you did stuff for me. So, you know, if you need something, then yeah, I got you. But just to meet you off rip and only know you for 2 weeks and you asking me to do this, oh no. Bye. It was nice knowing you. Good luck in life, because that's not me. I can't do it. I'm sorry. I don't care how good the penis is or whatever the case may be. I can't do it. Nope, I can't do it. I'd rather be by myself. My mom was 71 years old, and she was married to my dad for 11 years. And once my dad died, she never remarried again. And that was back in the 70s and 80s. She never remarried again. She met my sister's dad, and she was with him until the day she died. She never remarried again. And I don't know that I don't have the desire to get married. I'm 41 and I don't have a desire. I don't know if it's because I haven't met the right person or if they haven't jogged or sparked that marriage thing. But I never had a desire to get married, ever. Never. Like, I don't even think about it. I just don't. I wonder, is that like a bad example for my kids? You know, like they never seen their mom with nobody. They know their dads, but they never seen me with anybody. I don't know if that's good or bad, but you know, you got some women out here who lets their, who they take their kids around all their male friends, and that's crazy to me. Like, you don't take your kids around everybody. You just don't do it. You just don't. Every dude doesn't need to be around your kid. And I guess because of how my mom raised me, that's how I raised my kids. I don't, every man is not about to see my kid. My friends know I got kids, but they never seen them. And they never will see them. It's no purpose for you to see my kid if you're not in my life for a purpose. If you're not making a difference in my life, why do you need to be around my kids? That's weird to me. I don't let dudes around my kids. I don't even let females around my kids. I don't let my kids go spend a night over people's houses because I don't know what people do in their houses. You know, you might have Uncle Tom that's a pedophile. He likes little boys. That's his secret. Don't nobody know. But I let my son go over his friend's house and Uncle Tom is over there and there's nobody else there. And Uncle Tom sees the opportunity of one of his nephew's friends and that's my son and might take advantage. No, I don't let my kids go over no one else, nobody. Unless it's family, like, you know, my sister or their dad. That's the only way, and I don't even really trust that sometimes, but that's a whole nother story. I just don't let my kids go over other people's houses. It's not my thing. So much happens where people don't even put up their guns. They leave their guns laying around. And kids like, hey, come look at this, you know. And that's how kids get shot. I think about that stuff. And I wonder, do other parents think about that? Am I the only parent that thinks about that, you know? I think about so much. And it's not just like paranoid thoughts. It's things that should be common sense. You know? But people love to turn it into something mental quick. Oh, she's this, she's that. No, I'm not this and I'm not that. I think before I do stuff. If you have children, it's your job to protect them. Not to place them in the arms of freaking pedophiles and step parents that don't like them and does harm to them. No, that's not crazy. That's just being on top of your shit. You know what I'm saying? That's why I have some of these kids get killed because of their step parents, because in my case, the stepmom don't like me, so of course she's not gonna like my kid. And next thing I know, my kid is dead because of her. No, I'm sorry. I'm gonna be that protective mom. I'm gonna be like that mama bear that protects my kids until the day that I die. And I do not trust people, period, because people are evil. I don't care if people can call me crazy. You can call me whatever. But when it comes to my kids, I'm in my same mind and I'm a pit bull. And if you mess with them or you try to get them, I'm going to attack. Definitely going to attack. This conversation turned into something totally different. But, you know, it all stemmed from, it was time to have a conversation about something different anyway. You know, something different to talk about. Or listen about. I don't care if people come. If someone did stumble across this video and they made a comment and said, you're crazy, guess what? I don't give two fucks what you think. You know why? Because at the end of the day, you are not with me through my struggle. You do not pay my bills. There was a girl that I was locked up with. I'm not going to say her name. I really liked her. And the main thing about her is that she cared what other people thought about her. And I told her, I said, you gotta stop giving a fuck. You gotta stop caring what people think, because you're never going to make everyone happy. It's always gonna be that one bad apple that just is always in a bunch. It's always gonna be that one bad apple that's like, that criticizes you. No matter how good you progress, no matter how good you do, it's always going to be that one bad apple that always talks about you, that always makes a sarcastic comment, that's never going to have nothing good to say. And people live their lives off that. Like, they literally live off people's judgment of them. Like, if they're not approved by the people, they feel like they not shit. Me, I always been the opposite. If you don't like me, if you don't care about the things that come out my mouth, you don't have to follow me. You don't have to listen to me. You listen to me by choice because you want to listen to me. You don't have to, you don't even have to look at my face. You can cut the phone off anytime and just go to something else. But you're looking at me because you want to look at me. So because you want to look at me, you want to make judgment. And I don't care if you make judgment. You can make all the judgment in the world. You could talk about me till your face turn blue. I will never care. I don't give a fuck. That's why my problems is my problems. I don't take on the problems of other people's problems. I got my own problems to worry about. So you not liking me is like shit on the grass. I don't care. I will never care because you are not a factor. And that's what I wish that I was trying to tell her. But I guess it's just hard for some people to accept that when they're not accepted by others. If nobody accepts you, so what? If they don't like you, so what? If they talk about you, so what? They talked about Jesus. So if they talked about Jesus, what makes you think you're any different? They're going to talk about you too. So let them talk. That's all they can do is talk. They can't do anything else. They could just call you crazy, but you already know you're crazy a little bit because you're on crazy medications. They could call you weird. They can call you negative. You know what you are. As long as you're grounded and you're solid about what you are, it don't matter what nobody else has to say. Because like I said before, when you came in this world, you was born by yourself. And when you leave this world, you're going to leave by yourself. So if someone's talking about you, because I get a lot of people that try to cyberbully me when I was on Facebook. Oh, they tried to cyberbully me so bad. But it was just like, you know, bouncing off. Bitch, you can't cyberbully me. You know what the fuck I've been through? You can't say anything to me that's going to just make me upset unless it's something in my inner circle. Even I had people that talked about my dead mom. And I'm like, shit, you want to talk about my mom? Well, guess what? My mom's at peace because she's not on this hellhole earth anymore. Yes, I miss her to pieces. I miss her to death. Yes, I do. But you talking about my dead mom, that shit rolls off my arm like oil and water. Because at the end of the day, she's at peace. She's not here no more. I'm the one on this wicked earth. And I said, I pray sometimes and say, God, you created such a beautiful world with such evil people on it. The people that's on this earth, it's just, they're horrible. My lips are dry. They're so horrible. They are so, so, so horrible. But that's part of being strong. Not letting people get to you. I don't let people get to me. I've almost turned numb to a sense. It's not good to be numb. But in a way, it's a protective shield to protect you from people like my friend who she cares about what everybody think. I don't care what people think. You could think whatever you want about me. You could say the most harshest things about me. I don't care. I really don't. Even if you wanted to, like, shoot shots at my kids, because I have had people, since they couldn't get to me, they would shoot shots at my kids. Shoot shots at my kids. I don't care. Like, I told my son when he was younger, I said, if anybody says they want to talk about your mom, let them talk about me. I don't care. They'll never say it to my face. I bet you that. I bet you they won't say it to my face. They'll tell you to make you angry, but if someone be like, your mama this and your mama that, let them say it. Let them say it. Let them say whatever they want to say. If that's what makes them feel better at the end of the day, then guess what? You just help them get something off their chest by talking about me. But don't feed into it. Don't feed into it. Because you're not going to benefit from it. You're not at all. Let them talk about me. Don't get in no fights because somebody talked about your mama. That's dumb. It's stupid. They're just trying to push your buttons and make you mad. And I used to be, every time someone did something to me, it was like hitting my red button. My red button was getting hit all the time. But I played on a whole dirty level. Like, okay, bitch, you want to talk about me? I'm going to go for your ugly ass kids. That's what I'm going to do. And I know that's mean. I wouldn't hit your parents. I would find pictures of your kids and, you know what I'm saying, just be on some whole other bullshit. Like, bitch, I'm the last worry you need to worry about. You need to worry about these ugly ass kids that you produced on this earth and hoping that somebody don't come across them and make a baby with their ugly ass and keep that ugly generation curse going. You know, that's how I used to be. I don't want to be like that now. You know, I don't want to talk about innocent kids, but that's how bad my anger would be. That's because I was just, that was in my frustrated state, you know. And for me to vent like that, that was a relief. And this video is 32 minutes, so I hope you guys have a good day. I'm about to get up off this bed. Do something. Get up. If anybody see this video, keep going. Get up. Do one thing. One thing.